Hello students, welcome back to World of Home Science. Continuing with the textiles and clothing, we will go through selection of clothing in this video. Let's understand what is clothing. Clothing is one of our basic needs. Man has been using clothes since time immemorial. During the Stone Age, man covered his body using grass, leaves, tree bark, animal skin, etc. Gradually, with the advancement of civilization, man learned the art of weaving natural fibers. Till date, there is gradual development in the art of cloth making. The first response is that man wears clothes for modesty and social prestige. But now, clothes have become an integral part of our personality. Body structure and dress are part of one's external personality, whereas intelligence, outlook, interest and character, etc. are the part of inner personality. Clothes affect our physical, mental, social and emotional abilities and are deeply related to our personality. The dress reflects the social prestige and interest of the weaver. Clothing also adds variety to life and does away with monotony. Coming to the selection of clothing. Since clothes are an effective medium of reflecting our personality and interest, so selection of clothing becomes an important and essential subject matter. Its knowledge is must for every person. Selection of clothes seem to be simple, but being judicious in selection is very essential. The same person may look more graceful in a proper dress. An individual should wear clothes which are compatible to their personality and body figure. A good way of choosing proper clothes is one which fetches you maximum appreciation. In the selection of clothes, besides the durability and suitability of the cloth, beauty and personality of the wearer, personal experience is best guiding force. On account of later trends in clothing, the old knowledge becomes obsolete. We should choose such clothes as are satisfying by keeping in mind the general principle of clothing. There are some important points to be considered in selection of clothing, like age, season, fashion, income, and occasion. Let's go through one by one. Age. While selecting fabric, one has to think of the age group of the child. For small children, dainty prints in soft colors can be chosen. Nursery prints are not suitable for elementary school children. When the children enter late childhood stage, the boys like masculine colors like blue, grayish and brown, and girls like to wear feminine colors like pink, green, red, etc. Some fabrics which are delicate are chosen for girls' clothing, whereas rough textured fabrics are suitable for adolescent boys. The style of the dress also changes according to the age group of the child. The A-line dresses are suitable for toddlers and infants. Dresses with lots of gathers are suitable for girls' frock. Some type of collars are suitable for younger age group, whereas, for example, baby collar is not suitable for adolescent but for small children. Coming to next points, season. Some fibers and colors are suitable for winter, while others are not. For example, synthetic silk and wool are suitable for winters as they are bad conductor of heat. Cotton and blends of cotton with synthetics are good for summer as they are good conductor of heat and are absorptive. They are comfortable in summer. There are warm and cool colors. The cool colors are associated with coolness. For example, blue, green, white, etc. Warm colors are bad conductors of heat and associated with warmth. For example, red, golden, yellow, orange, etc. So warm colors are suitable for winter, whereas cool colors are chosen for summer. Fashion. Fashionable clothes look beautiful. They look odd when they go out of fashion. Some clothes should be bought according are in fashion, while others are not. Children belonging to high income group can wear fashionable clothes to great extent as compared to low income group. Extremes of fashion should be avoided. Next point, which is to be considered while selecting clothing, is income. amount of money affects the selection of clothing. Children belonging to high income group can spend more percentage of money on clothing as compared to low income group. They can spend more money on fashionable garments rather than on durable clothes. Parents belonging to low income group prefer durable clothes rather than delicate ones. So the preferences of the clothing changes according to the income of the family. Low socioeconomic group give more importance to durability, comfort and price as compared to becomingness and beauty, etc. Occasion. Selection of clothes also changes according to occasion. For daily wear or informal wear, durable dresses with simple designs can be chosen. But for occasional or formal wear, novel fabrics with new styles are chosen. Dresses with trimmings and decorations are selected. These fabrics can be dry cleaned if required. Let's see selection of clothing for different age group. Clothing of the infant, 8 to 9 months. The three musts in clothing the newborn baby are warmth, comfort and hygienic qualities. Outside his mother's womb, the newborn baby will react to the variable temperature of his new environment. Babies heat up and cool off more quickly than do grown-ups. Thus, they have to be watched very carefully in climates where there are sudden changes of temperature. During the few months of life, the baby will sleep 80% of his time and must have comfortable clothing for sleeping. The amount and type of clothing which the infant will need will be determined to some extent by the time of the year, general climatic conditions, warmth of the child's room and condition of the infant. The most suitable fiber for the infant's clothing is cotton because it is soft and can be kept hygienically safe washing in extremely hot or boiling water. Key points one must consider for the selection of infant's clothing include: infant's clothes should be selected primarily on the basis of comfort and ease of care. Garments which need no ironing are easy to put on the baby and have no hard or rough surface to cause discomfort are considered most suitable. Baby clothes should be soft and pliable and never irritating. Clothes should be provide ventilation to allow any moisture to evaporate. Inadequate ventilation causes moisture to stay next to the baby's sensitive skin and may result in skin irritations. Clothing should be simple and well made. Fancy trimmings require extra care in laundering and often irritate the baby. Knit fabric garments strengthen with body movements and are easy to put on the infant. Openings all the way down the front or back made dressing simpler. Ties or flat fasteners are more comfortable. A drawstring at the neckline is not recommended because the infant might become caught in the strings. If ties or buttons are used, they should be inspected often. Make sure that they are sewed securely. Clothing for preschool child, 2 to 6 years. Clothing for preschool age child may become a major problem for the family because it is expensive, yet is used for only a short period of time. It should be selected to help the child develop self-reliance, practice social skills, interact with peers. Garment should be flexible, comfortably warm, easily cleaned, soft in nature, durably constructed to encourage self-reliance, convenient for frequent toileting, adjustable to the rapidly growing body and attractive in design and fabric. Children of this age also need make-believe clothing to accommodate their dream world of fantasies. Key points for selection of preschoolers' clothing. Number of cloths. Many factors affect the size and content of child's wardrobe. A cold climate requires more clothing than a warm one. The social status of the parents will determine the quality as well as quantity of the child's clothing. Fitting. The preschool child needs clothing that fits close to the body and is free from dangling ties or ornamentation that might catch on things. Drawstrings at the neck or waist and long ties on hoods and caps are dangerous. Quality. Quality should be light in weight with a maximum warmth and protection. A good quality fabric with a firm, close weave made of firmly twisted yarns that will not wrinkle or soil easily is preferable for most outer garments. Inner wears should be of loosely woven or knit fabric to provide body ventilation and absorb moisture. While selecting the clothing for preschoolers, we must see allowance for growth. Growth is most rapid during the preschool years. Buying clothes with growth features will enable a garment to be worn over a longer period of time, like skirts and dresses with deep hems or tucks at the bottom, overalls with adjustable long straps and deep cuffs or hems, stretch fabric, two-piece garments, etc. Self-help features. A self-help garment is one which the child can put on and take off with a little or no help from an adult. The experience of learning how to dress himself makes the child more independent and self-confidence. For example, log openings located for easy reach, front openings are easier to handle than back or side openings, large buttons or fasteners are easier to manage than small ones. The back of a garment should be easily distinguishable from the front. Ease of care. The workmanship is of such quality as to withstand frequent laundering and hard wear. Seams should be well finished. Fasteners should be as flat as possible. There should not be sharp or pointed edges. Clothing for adolescents. Adolescents want well-fitted, fashionable, and expensive garments. Comfort and serviceability are sacrificed for the sake of style and fashion. They are greatly interested in clothing and concerned with their physical appearance. Clothing becomes a means of expressing personality. Key points in the selection of clothing for adolescents include occasion. They select their clothes according to the occasion. Some dresses with decorative designs and shiny appearance are suitable for party wear, and dresses with a simple design and easy to wash are mostly chosen for daily wear. Season. Dark colors look cheerful in winter. During summer, light colors are appropriate. Sheer textures are suitable for summer, for example, organdy and chiffon. Fabrics with shiny surfaces are chosen for winter, for example, silk. Points to be considered while selecting clothing for adolescents. Figure. As adolescents are developing physically, they either want to conceal or show off their figure. Lines. Vertical lines make the person to appear tall and thin, whereas horizontal lines will have opposite effect. Neckline and collars. A round face looks best above a pointed collar or simple V-style neckline. An angular face gains softness with a round collar. Color. Light and gray colors are suitable for short and thin adolescents. Sleeves. Narrow shoulders are at their best in raglan sleeves that avoid the set armholes. Concern with the fitting of the garments. Fitting is the major problem for girls. Dresses rapidly come too short waisted and too tight across the bust and requires frequent lengthening. Pant and shirt or coat sleeves become too short, add to the already awkward look of the boys. Fashion. Adolescents are more concerned about fashionableness of a garment than its durability. They are attached by style, fabric, and patterns worn by friends. Clothing fads are more prevalent during this age period, which is called as adolescence. That's for now. This is me, Vijaya, signing off. If you find the content of this video useful, do like, share and subscribe. Comment for your suggestions. For future Home Science videos, stay tuned. Bye-bye.